Hello, my name is David Faure and I work for KDAB. Welcome to this new video in the series Multithreading with Qt. Today's video is going to be about thread safety. Can you call methods on an object that is shared between threads? Also, can you call the same method in different objects that live in different threads? And what about QObject? Is that thread safe? Let's have a look at a few definitions. The first one is thread safe. A function is thread safe if it can be called from multiple threads without any kind of synchronization, even though it's working on the same data. Usually that means there is some synchronization inside of the function. A function is re-entrant if we can call it from different threads on different instances of the data. This is the case for most functions, as long as they don't have any kind of internal static data. Non-reentrant means you cannot call this function from more than one thread at all. A few examples: any standard atomic would be thread safe, while QString is reentrant. You can use different QString instances in different threads. And if you want an example of something that is unsafe, that would be, for instance, the setEnv method from the libc. You cannot call this from multiple threads because the underlying data is not protected and it is shared between the different threads. And when we say this about functions, it means for a class to be thread safe, all of its methods have to be thread safe. For a class to be reentrant, all of its methods have to be reentrant, and so on. So if you look at Qt, there are a few thread safe classes like qmutex. Obviously it is okay to use qmutex, the same instance in different threads. That's the whole point. We can call qobject connect from multiple threads on the same object, that's fine. And we can do things like posting events on the same QCore application. There is only one, and that's fine. Basically, it means there is a mutex inside. On the other hand, the following classes are reentrant, meaning that we can use different instances in different threads. I can use different QStrings, different vectors, different images. This is fine, but I have to be very careful if I use the same instance in many threads. And then we have classes that are not reentrant. We cannot use them in multiple threads at all. And we talked about this in a previous video. Anything that touches the GUI has to be done from the main thread. So classes like QWidget, QPixMap, all of these things are not reentrant. You should use them only from the main thread. So obviously this list is small. There are many more classes in Qt. But if we look at the documentation for classes in Qt, we can see if they are reentrant that is going to be written in the class. And we can see for a few methods, if they are marked as thread safe, this is going to be documented as well. If nothing is documented, you should be careful and assume that it's not reentrant. All right, what about QObject in all of this? QObject is thread aware, which means it knows a particular thread and it lives in that thread. By default, this is the thread that creates the object. We say that the object lives in a thread or has affinity with a thread when this thread is the one that handles events for that object. If we want, we can change that and we can move the object to a different thread, meaning from now on, this other thread will handle the events for the object. So that means QObject is reentrant, right? We can use different object instances in different threads, but we have to be careful because it's not thread safe. The event handling happens in a single thread. We just talked about that. Also, you have to know that all of the parents and children in the same tree of objects, they all have to live in the same thread. So that's why, if you remember from a previous video where we created a QThread instance inside of a worker object, we said the QThread instance cannot have a parent. It needs to be created with no parent because it lives in a different thread than the worker, so we cannot pass a parent there. And when we move an object to a different thread, all of the children are going to be moved as well, and that's why we couldn't do that. So you have to be careful when you do this the other way around. You derive from QThread and you create objects. You shouldn't pass the thread as a parent to these objects because they live in different threads. And if you do this wrong, you will get warnings from Qt at runtime. This also means you should delete all of the QObjects that live in a certain thread before you terminate the thread. Otherwise, any events sent to those objects cannot properly be processed because there is no thread anymore to do that. And also that means you can't really properly delete these objects because you don't really know at what time to do that. If you delete an object while the thread is handling its events, you will have problems, obviously. One thing to know about move to thread is that it's push only. You can only give an object from the current thread to another thread. You cannot steal an object from another thread because that's going to be racy with the event handling for that object in the other thread. So think of it as push only. It's all about giving, it's not about stealing. So overall, on a given object instance, we can call methods only in a specific thread, the one that handles the all of the event handling happens in that thread. And if you want to be able to call methods from a different thread, you need to add synchronization, usually with a mutex. This is all for today's video. In the next video, we will talk about what you've been waiting for, signals and slots between objects in different threads. Thank you for watching.